because he had learned that in God, we live and move and have our being. When you are haunted by God, nothing else can get in. No cares, no tribulations, no anxieties can get in. The psalmist teaches us that if you want to have peace, you have to let go of the sin of worry. I'm going to stop right there. Because some of y'all have been worrying yourself to death about nonsense. Nonsense. And it's saying right here, here's the key word to the thought. Sin of worry. In other words, you Christians out there, and some back here, and some in here, in this pulpit, it's a sin for Christians to work.
Come on.
That's what the psalmist said. Y'all don't worry yourself to death about nothing. And on top of that, you're going to sin as you were. Because that's what he said. The life of a true believer is hid with Christ. And that's what keeps us at peace, even in the midst of a storm. Remember when Jesus, they was out there in the ocean, and there was a storm coming in.
Yeah, come on.
And Jesus, he got a pillow and went to sleep. And the disciples said, "You sleeping, Jesus, and we gonna pay." Now this ain't in here, but I'm gonna give you this for free. They were worried about perishing, and Jesus, he was taking a nap, got a pillow, and relaxed. And I come to wonder, why was the disciples worried in a storm when they had Jesus on a pillow in the boat taking a nap?
Yeah.
I ain't gonna worry about nothing ever again. Cause we got Jesus in our boat.
Yeah.
But he ain't sleeping. He's constantly on the job. He's putting angels.
Come on, Ralph.
So you shouldn't be worried about silly stuff. But let me hear you. That was for free. I ain't going to charge you for that.
All right.
It's saying, when we allow life to haunt us, we rob ourselves of the marvelous revelation of our companionship with God. Oh, Lord. That God is our refuge and strength. Is that what I say here? I want to tell you no lie. It's a verse that what it says. That God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. That's Psalm 46 and 1. Y'all believe y'all can make me late. So we learn from the psalmist that serving God produces confidence in God. But we also learn another thing, that a relationship with God guarantees longevity. Let me break that down. Longevity. Longevity. The psalmist says, "O Lord, you alone are my hope. I've trusted you from childhood." You get the distinct impression that the psalmist has reached his 310 milestone. But if not, he certainly has a track record with the Lord. In other words, he done got old. I ain't trying to do no math. He done got old. That's what I'm saying. The truth is, we don't think about the length of our lives until we reach our senior years.
Yeah.
Okay. Hold on. Don't leave yet. Hold up. Most of us tend to take life for granted, to assume that we will reach the final phase of our existence unscathed, It's not until we get to the age of 60 or 65 that we begin to realize